AutoCAD hatch problems. No. AutoCAD hatches can be very frustrating, like my client, who has AutoCAD program crashes every time he uses the hatch command. Luckily for him, I could fix his problem and send his file back. But my client asked, what did I mess up? So this hatch issue and five more, we're gonna fix and go over today. Are you ready? So one of the most common hatch problems in AutoCAD is this error that I have on my screen, that it's a closed boundary could not be determined. So let me show you when you will see this first common hatch problem. So for instance, I want to hatch this area, right, with the same brick as this other area. And look what happened when I use the H shortcut for calling for the hatch command. So if I select an area here, boom, you will have this common hatch problem or error. A closed boundary could not be determined. And basically we can, you know, go and read the description, but in simple words, what's going on here is that there is no enclosed or closed boundary of this area. So, and if we click close, we can see that, of course, at this point, sometimes AutoCAD give you signs with a red circle where is the open area or boundary. But since I did this drawing intentionally, I know that the open area is right here. So that's what is causing the issue. So of course, I could simply close this area and I will be ready to go. However, when you have a more complex drawing, right, it would be hard for you to start closing all of these areas. So if this is the case, let me show you how we can fix this better. So let's try again the hatch command. And what we can do here is to fix this common hatch problem. There is a handy option under options, of course, over here. And there is an option that says gap tolerance. So if we increase that, I'm going to increase it, for instance, to 1, right? And then I can go here and try the hatch again. So I'm going to click again. And now we have a different message. It says, do you want to continue hatching this area? Look what happened when I click yes on the continue hatching area. So boom, as you can see, your hatch now, it's fine. So at this point, I can simply press enter, right? So that's one trick to fix the a closed boundary could not be determined. Again, increase the gap tolerance to, you know, a size that it's particular to your opening. In this case, mine, it was around 1 inch to 2 inches and so on. All right. So the next hatch problem, common hatch problem, is the one about trimming hatches. Yes. So sometimes happen, I'm going to go to another drawing over here. To sometimes happens that when you try to trim a hatch, for instance, let's try to make an opening here on this hatch. So, and if you try to trim, so right now it's working, of course, but sometimes you cannot trim hatches. Let's see if I have that arrow. Like this, you can see that it says a message, cannot trim this object. and you see a little icon, you know, a circle with a line over there. So this is common sometimes with hatches that you are not able to trim. However, if you try to zoom in or out, for instance, I'm gonna go like this, zoom in and out, sometimes you can fix that problem. Like right now, I see the X showing up, which of course is gonna trim my hatch. And all I did was simply zoom in or zoom out like that, right? So try that trick whenever you are not able to trim a hatch in AutoCAD. All right, so that's another common problem, trimming hatches in AutoCAD. And let's keep moving with the next one. The next common hatch problem is the one that my client had, which was freezing or crashing AutoCAD when using the hatch command. And for that, of course, I had to go back to my client comment that he had this issue. AutoCAD program crashes every time I use hatch command. So he sent me his file. Of course, I'm gonna tell you how I did fix it. He sent me the file and I sent the file back fixed, but he wanted to know what did I mess up on. So let me show you now how I did it. Of course, I cannot open the exact file that my client sent me because, of course, for security reasons, but all I did was when AutoCAD crashes every time you use the hatch command, all I did was first open the file and checked that the file wasn't containing thousands of objects. For instance, I selected one of the lines on my client's drawing and opened my property palette. And when I did that and went to line types, I saw hundreds of different line types. In this case, of course, I just have a few, but in his drawing, he had hundreds of different line types. And the same happened with the text. When I selected one of the text on my client's drawing and went to text styles, he had hundreds of different text styles. And immediately I knew that something weird was happening with his file. And the next thing I did was I went to the location of his file, in this case, by right clicking here and open file location. And I checked the size of the file, of my client's file, right? And it was huge. So immediately I knew that I needed to remove all of these different textiles, line types, and so on. So all I did was purge the drawing, right, with the regular purge command. So I could clean that up. And of course, I did all, purge all, purge all checked items. And then I did close. So after that, of course, I just verified it that all of the different textiles didn't exist anymore on the drawing, as well as the line types. And then I was able to hatch nicely without AutoCAD crashing or freezing. So that's the solution for that particular or very common AutoCAD hatch problem. So check your file size, clean it up, purge the items or line times or textiles not used, and the problem will be solved. So let's keep moving with the next one. And the next one is the problem of the hatch scale. Yes. So sometimes it's very common actually. For that, I'm gonna go to this other drawing. It's very common that when you use hatches, for instance, let's say I want to use this same hatch over here on this wall. So if I use the hatch command, and of course I'm gonna select that pattern because that's what I need. But the scale of my, so if I use the hatch command, sometimes comes in a different size or scale. So that's a problem, right? So in order to avoid that, what I like to do is open my tool palette. Of course, you can open it with Control 3. So Control 3 will open your tool palette. I'm gonna lock it in here. And what I like to do to avoid hatch scale problems is when I have my hatch that I want to use over and over, and I have the correct scale, in this case 48, I like to click or left click and drag it to my tool palette. So once I release it, and let's say I want to hatch this wall over here, I can simply use it from my tool palette. And the beauty of this is that once I click, of course there is a probably an opening there, but let's try this wall over here. All right, so you will see that it has exactly the same scale. Not only that, but also the same properties. So, and this is because if I right click on this and choose properties, you will see that the settings, the same settings as the other hatch are there, such as the scale, 48, and so on. So that's one way that you can use this technique to have or solve for the hatch scale problems in AutoCAD. All right, so let's keep moving with the next hatch or common hatch problem. In this case, not having the right hatch. This is very common in AutoCAD because AutoCAD only gives us the most used hatches, but sometimes we need more than that. So let me go back here in this drawing to show you how we can fix that. And let's say, for instance, I want a hatch here, a metal panel hatch for this roof. So, and if I use the hatch command, of course, if I check here, I don't have that specific hatch, metal panel hatch. So what I can do is to solve this issue, let's say you don't have the hatch that you need, you can go online and of course find and download a hatch pattern. That's very easy to do. You can simply Google it, right? But once you have the hatch pattern, like in my case, so I downloaded it, let's say a hatch pattern, and then I'm gonna save it in a folder that I remember. So this is the hatch that I want, metal panel. So what I can do to fix the problem is, or add this hatch to my AutoCAD program, is simply open the options using the shortcut OP, and under support file search path, I can expand that out and then click add. So once I do that, I can simply hit browse to find the folder where my hatch patterns are stored. So in my case, it's right here, hatch patterns, and I'm gonna simply click open. So once I do that and click apply, I can click OK. And now the next time I need this specific hatch pattern, I can simply use the hatch command and boom. If I go and scroll down, my metal panel, it's right there for me available. This would be available in any drawing. So at this point, I can simply hatch that and change the scale if I need it, like so. Right? So those were five of the most common problems regarding to AutoCAD. As always, this live stream and this other video on your screen comes thanks to my supporters, either on YouTube as a member or on Patreon. Thank you very much, and I'll see you on this next video so we can keep saving time in AutoCAD.